All right, time to wake up.
We're awake.
Push one of the chairs back.
All that good stuff.
Tim, stay awake.
Get this back over here. All right, so we are full of the natural food. Is anybody hungry for some spiritual food?
Amen.
Okay, well, I got like this little corner right here. Let's try it again. Is anybody hungry for some spiritual food?
Amen.
There we go.
Amen.
There we go. Praise God. Praise God for what he's done. Once again, happy Thanksgiving, everybody. For those who are watching on YouTube, I hope you have a very happy Thanksgiving as well. Please subscribe to our channel. Hit the little notification thing that does the ding. Does that ding that every time that we put a new video on, we do. These are pre-recorded as far as that goes, so you won't see this till tomorrow on YouTube. But we are doing that right now, no Facebook Live. So if you want to be with us live as it is happening right now, you just got to come be with us. Amen?
Amen.
There's something special about that in-person worship and in-person fellowship. It just, it always has a very powerful flow to it in that sense. I'm telling you, I'm struggling a little bit. My belly is full.
We're the same
hope. Yeah. There we go. Amen. Amen. But I'm just going to... I don't think we've got any other announcements other than Happy Thanksgiving. Yep, pretty blank unless we know something. We are trying to work on some stuff. We're doing something for Christmas, so details to come on that because that conversation literally just got started today. So we're still getting there on that. But praise God, he is good, right? Just want to share a quick testimony before we get into everything else. But yesterday at work, I don't get a chance to do this very often, but opportunity arose for God to do some work. Conversation was going on, and I basically just got the opportunity just to kind of pray over someone and say, God, just show them your love, your mercy, and your grace. And the person instantly talked about how just heat started running through their body and tingling and stuff like that. So I know God was doing a work in them. Amen? More than coffee. I can tell you that. It was more than coffee. Amen, Mick?
No.
Anyway, somebody tell me something you're thankful for. It is, I mean, it's a season. Thanksgiving's Thursday, so something you're thankful for.
I'm thankful for my wife's continual improvement in her health after being down for 6 weeks. Months, I mean, and it just does my heart good to walk in there and see her at the sink washing some dishes. Or
that's just because she don't have to do it anymore.
that's part of it. Yeah. But I appreciate her probably a whole lot more because of being able to do things for her, but realize how much she does contribute to our life, and she's getting back there. It's not 100%. She doesn't do all the cooking. She doesn't do all the dishwashing. But it is so encouraging.
Amen. It is.
I'm thankful.
What else?
I am thankful not only for my biological family, but for my family in Jesus Christ. I love you all so very much. Yeah, the best.
I know.
I'm thankful that God spared Justin's life, spared Amber's life, spared Alicia's life all ago.
Yes.
And I'm also praising Jesus that Michelle Giles come home from the hospital, even though she passed away this week. She got saved, she got baptized, and hallelujah, praise God.
Amen. That's the important part. Amen. Anyone else?
I'm very grateful. There's so many things that I'm grateful for. It's hard to. We've all got so much,
Yes.
I'm grateful that God has made it through his touch spell. I pray we don't have to go through another one. I'm grateful that we're all healthy and that Corona has not taken us.
Amen.
I'm grateful that we're in the hands of Jesus and he's in control and we just trust him. I'm just grateful. I just feel very humble anymore. You know what I'm saying? When I look around at this world and see the conditions, and I'm very, very grateful and very humbled that I'm his child.
Amen. And you know, just speaking of what you said, something I'm thankful for, I've become even more thankful for it over this past year. With all the stuff that's happened in the government and all that, and everything that they're trying to suppress and do all those things, it's made me even more thankful for the rights we do have in this country.
Yes.
The right that we have in this wonderful nation to come to, and assemble together freely,
yes,
without having to really have any backlash. That's not something that happens all over the world. Some countries you can, if you assemble in the name of Jesus, you're liable to come in and everyone get killed.
Yeah.
It literally can happen. It happens here in this world. And I just think to myself, all these people talking about in the United States how they're suffering for this and that, and I'm thinking, you know what? I am thankful that we live in a country where we are blessed,
yes,
to be able to worship God openly.
Yes.
We should not take that for granted. Amen.
Amen.
I'm also thankful for how much I have grown in the Lord in the last year. I still have struggles every day, but I am so thankful. I have my joy back.
Amen.
And the devil ain't going to defeat me. I'm too daggone stubborn.
That's right.
He's already defeated.
One of the things that I try to thank my God for on a regular basis, I go out every morning for my prayer walk, and I just praise him for the peace. I know we've had people come there to the farm and talk about being so peaceful. Well, all of us have peace within us because we've got God's Holy Spirit.
Amen.
But sometimes we do have the physical surroundings that add to that peace. And we're back there in the sticks, away from so much, and I think about the fear that's taken over the people around us over some little virus they can't even isolate, perhaps, and so on. And they're so fearful. Everything is so unpeaceful, if you will. And we just have that peace, and that,
yeah,
we can rest in God and in Jesus, and just know that his love for us, and we're being taken care of and watched over and provided for, and all our cares can be put upon him. And there's just that's a wonderful thing to be able to thank him for that peace.
Yes.
Amen.
I want to thank God for my salvation, most of all.
Amen.
Yes. Thank you, Jesus.
We take it for granted a lot. But the truth of the matter is, if it wasn't for salvation, wouldn't none of us be here.
Amen.
None of us would be alive. None of us would be able to breathe. Me and my situation, where he brought me from, I'd be dead right now if it wasn't for salvation.
Amen.
When I received God, I didn't just receive God. I got delivered from drugs and alcohol. I got delivered from bounties that was on my head. Like, what man on earth can just say, oh, you didn't got to do that? When a gang puts a bounty on your head, they can't. In the gang world, it takes the man that put the bounty on the head to relieve it. But God saved my life from that.
Amen.
I can't praise him enough for salvation in my family. For as young as we are, we have one of the biggest families there is. But they're blessed.
Amen.
Yes.
Amen.
I want to thank God. I praise him for bringing me out of the struggles I've been going through.
Yeah.
I've been going through a lot in the past year. And I just know in the past couple months I've been going through a lot, but just in this past week, I've had 3 job offers.
Amen.
Laid in my lap.
Amen.
And I feel a lot better about the way things are turning around. And if it wasn't for God, I wouldn't be sitting here right now.
He's God of breakthrough.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yes.
Speaking of which, I mean, I'm thankful for Breakthrough Ministries.
Yes.
We're still young.
Yes.
We're still growing. We're still doing what we're doing, and we're doing it in the will of God the best we know how, and we'll continue to flow in that. Amen?
Amen.
I love being a part of Breakthrough in the sense that, first off, I love new things. And realizing that you get to that place, and it just comes to me so many times in Isaiah where he says, forget the former things.
Come on.
For I'm about to do something new. And I know breakthrough is a part of that something new. It truly is. And I don't know what it's going to look like in the future. And to be honest, as long as God's in it, I don't care what it looks like, as long as he's in it. Amen?
Amen.
As long as he's doing his thing, that's all that matters to me in it. I'm so excited about that. I'm so excited to see everybody here. I'm so thankful about it. And, I mean, we got Thanksgiving, then right after that, Christmas, we're celebrating the birth. And that's, to me, that's what Christmas is.
Yes.
I mean, I love the decorations, don't get me wrong. I love all the pretty lights and all of that. But it's when it boils right down to it, those lights should be representing the light that was born.
Yes.
The light that was born, because he is our light. He is the one that brings us out of the darkness, brings us to the places we need to be. Just like what Brian said, he's thankful for salvation. You know what? It's God's salvation, and he gives it to us freely.
Amen.
Come on.
He gives it to us freely. That's so amazing. That's so awesome. And I really wasn't planning on getting into that right now. But anyway, praise God for all of that. Amen?
Amen.
So, before we get into the music, I do want to share with you a couple ways that you can give to Breakthrough Ministries if you so choose. You can go to the Cash App, cash.app/$Breakthrough42129 for any type of online giving you want to do. You can mail it through just your regular mail to 436 Yellowhammer Road, Columbia, Kentucky, 42728. And Teresa will take care of that. And then if you're here in person and you just want to give a check or whatever, you can. There's a bucket back there, and there's one over here. Okay. If you give it during the time of worship, I suggest you go back there to that one, because it's going to be loud right over there. That gets a little loud. Cassandra can take, because she's closest to it. Tim can really tell you, because the first service we had here, the computer was over there, and he said, I got to move. He said, it's too loud, I got to move.
We need to thank God for Tim, too, because he's our sound person.
Yes. Yes, definitely. Thankful for he's not just the sound person. I mean, he does so much. So definitely very thankful for all that you do, Tim. You are definitely a big part of Breakthrough Ministries in that. I know you don't talk a lot, you don't want to be noticed a lot, but give credit where credit is due in that. God, yes. God is using you for many things in that. Definitely.
Not everybody talks like the women do.
Not everybody talks like you do, Tracy.
Good Lord, make me the way you wanted me to be. That's right.
Yeah.
I love you.
God, I'm sorry. That's my cousin.
There goes his pizza for Christmas.
No, it's not. It's no way. Anyway. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Praise God.
Praise God.
Are you ready to praise and worship?
Yes.
That's not convincing. Are you ready to praise and worship our Lord Jesus Christ?
Yes.
All right, let's stand on your feet. Lord, we give this time to you right now. We come before you. We honor you. We thank you for all that you do. We know that you are almighty. We know that you are powerful. We know that there is no one greater than you, Lord. But what we know most of all, Lord, is the fact of how much you love us. And we don't even fully comprehend how much that love is. So we come before you, walking in that love, because you tell us that we love because you first loved us. So right now, Lord, we're just coming before you, and we're just giving that love back. We're just giving it back to you, Lord, so that you can give more, we give more, so that that flow just keeps going, God. We thank you, we praise you, and it is your time, Lord. We give this time to you, to where we praise, honor, and glorify you in Jesus' name. And all God's children says,
Amen.
Let's try this one time.
Praise God.
I remember how he told me that life may not be easy. holy. I can trust you completely. So why am I doubting when you prove that you'd fight for me? You walked me through fire.
Jesus.
Praise you, Jesus. Wow. God says some crazy things, you guys. He is doing some crazy, crazy, crazy things. Cassandra, come here. I got this sucker out. This is my prayer shawl that I got from Israel. Amber, can you come help me here real quick? Somebody help me put this over her. Yeah. You were about ready to help, weren't you?
Yeah.
It's coming over you.
Nice job.
Just turn around. I'm going to pray over you. All I know is in the midst of this is that God's given me some words, and now he's given even more words, and he's just telling me just to give them right now. They've got one more song to do, you guys, but in the midst, lay it on. Just lay it over. Lay it over. In the midst of these, and I'm not one for big for rituals and traditions and all of this, and I know this is a prayer shawl represent all holy Old Testament, but you know what? It's still New Testament too, okay? Because there's a covering that God gives us, an anointing that God gives us and puts over us in all types of different things, and I just thank God for it. And right now, just in the name of Jesus, Cassandra, I just speak those things that you've been waiting for, that you've been saying to God, I'm here, God, let's do this, God. He's saying, okay, let's do it. It's happening right now. In Jesus' name, the things you've been waiting for him to fulfill, they are coming to pass as we speak. They are boiling up in your heart. They are boiling up even in your mouth. And it's just like what Jeremiah said. There's a fire burning inside of you, Cassandra, that you cannot hold back anymore. It's got to be unleashed. And that's what's happening right now. It's coming into you. So God, I thank you right now for what you're doing over Cassandra. I thank you, God, for the movement that you are moving in this woman and the souls that are going to be touched, the souls that are going to be saved through what you are going to do through and in her, Jesus. So Holy Spirit, just touch her right now. Just touch her. Just touch her right now. In Jesus' name. 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 Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Feel the fresh wind blow over you, sister. Feel it blow over you. Hallelujah. 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 Gently take that off of her and just hold it for me for just a second. Just hold it up. Because the words that God has given me, he's told me to every person that I'm giving a word to right now to put that over. I don't know why. That's just what he's doing. Brandy, can you come up here for a second?
You feel that? Hey.
First thing God wants to tell you is that he wants you to know that you're his daughter. Mm-hmm. Not just any daughter, but a very special daughter to him. And he loves you deeply. Doesn't matter what's going on everywhere else, his love is still there for you. Mm-hmm. His love is so there for you. thing that the Lord showed me. He told me to tell you that first. Because what he's saying to you right now, it's not that he misses spending time with you. He misses your praises. And he's saying, I'm giving them back to you right now. He's opening the door for you to praise deeper and more passionately than you ever have before. And it may not feel that way right now, but he is doing that because he wants to see you shine the way that you are meant to shine. And he's also telling you this, that he doesn't remember what you went through. You know that. It's gone as far as the east is, but he doesn't remember that. All he knows you as is his perfect daughter. It's his perfect daughter that he loves and cares about so compassionately and deeply. So Lord, right now, just in the name of Jesus, I thank you for Brandy. I thank you for her, Lord, and I ask you right now, Lord, I'm just asking you to fulfill your word in her right now, Lord, that the word you gave to give me to her, that her praise is going to come, not just come back, but it's going to come back more powerful and more strongly than it ever has before. That she, a birthing right now, a birthing of praise is coming into Brandy that she has never expected. That she didn't think it was going to happen, but it's happening right now. A birth of praise and worship to where people, she may not be up in the front singing, but people are going to see her praising and worshiping God and realize that this whole thing of raising hands and getting excited for Jesus is the real deal because they see the trueness of it in Brandy. We see the trueness of it in her. She doesn't have to be on the stage, Jesus. You don't have to be on the stage for it to happen, Brandy. People are going to see you. They're going to see you in the corner praising and worshiping and saying, I need what she's got. And they're going to get it just by seeing you. Just like from Peter's shadow, Brandy, hallelujah. Just like when people are getting healed from Peter's shadow, people are going to get healed and rescued just from seeing you praise. Because the flow of him who you are praising is going to come off of you and just go into them. That glory is going to just magnify into them and heal them of things that they didn't even know was wrong. And you know the reason why he's going to do all this with you, Brandy? Because he loves you. He loves you so much that he wants to use you in that way. He wants to use you. So, Lord, right now, I thank you, Lord. And I just ask right now for a fresh refilling right now, overflowing of the Holy Spirit on Brandy right now, from the top of her head to the very tips of her toes and the tips of her fingers, her entire body, Lord. Just let that mighty rushing wind just come blowing over her and into her right now in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Thank you, Lord. You got 7-4 ready to go for it.
And as you lift your hands, and as you begin to open your mouth and praise him out loud, hallelujah, miracles are going to begin to take place from within right here in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Praise his holy name. Hallelujah, God. We praise your holy name.
The birth of praise of your
holy name. Hallelujah. Jesus. Jesus. Fire. Fire. Hallelujah. Holy Ghost. Fire. Holy Ghost. Holy Ghost. Fire.
Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. She, love you, sister. Thank you, Lord. Brian, come up here. I can't get away from this. I don't even know what it is, but he's holding this box out of you, so come up here. Before y'all put this on him, just like I told Brandon, brother, you're gonna feel something, so let's just go on. But you're gonna feel, what you're gonna feel is a burning like you've never felt before. As soon as this thing hits your head, it's gonna be a burning like you've never felt before in a good way. God's got a calling on you, you know that. He's got a specific calling on you, and you know that. But what he's telling me right now, Brian, is you're trying too hard, brother. You need to stop. Let him do his thing. Let him do his thing. You're trying too hard. Just let him do it. It's not like Yoda where it says, do or do not, there is no try in this, there is no do, there is no do not, there is no try. It is you let him do it. It's let or let not. You have to let him do it. Let him do it, brother. And if you're ready for that right now, I just want you to say just what Isaiah said. Here I am, send me. Woo! So Lord, right now, in Jesus' name, in Jesus' name, in Jesus' name, Holy Spirit, touch him. Move in him in the ways he needs to move. Mold him in the way you need to mold him. And just like you said, here am I, send me. He's saying, here I am, Lord. He's saying, here I am. And I know with what he's saying that I can speak for him right now. He's saying, here I am. Do with me as you see fit. Do what you need to do to me. So, Lord, right now, I just say right now, in Jesus' name, you do to Brian what you need to do to him. In this very instance, you move over him the way you need to move over him. Holy Spirit, just break all into him right now. In Jesus' name. 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 Thank you, Lord.
When you spoke the words, here I am, Lord, send me. I saw the mantle of Elijah being placed over you. If you will walk in that wholeheartedly, he'll give you the double portion. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Praise your holy name. Thank you, Jesus. Have your way, Lord. Have your way. Yes,
Woo, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. There may be more words, but I feel right now is the time for the song, ladies.
Okay.
I think it's time.
Just carry on worshiping the Lord.
Yes, just carry on.
Will you sing Fires again? That's your way. Or wait, wait. What she said. Thank you.
It's the first one.
Thank you.
I remember how you told me that life may not be easy. Everything that I need, you've already given me. I remember how you told me I can trust you completely. So why am I doubting when you prove that you fight for me?
There's a table that you
If you didn't know he was good before this, you should know now that he is good for what he Amen. He's doing some awesome and powerful things.
Yes.
For two or three are gathered.
Yes. Yes. He's giving me a little bit of a word. Maybe 5 minutes, maybe 50 minutes, I don't know, but we're just letting the Holy Spirit go, but I do know that I need to say this. So we're just going to let him say what he needs to say, amen? Amen. If it changes up, it needs to go more directions, it'll go more directions. If I need to step out of the way, I need to step out of the way. Whatever God wants to do, God's going to do, amen?
Amen.
That's what we're going to do. We're going to go by his plan, not ours.
Come on.
Hey,
brother.
Yes?
Whenever you feel like we should do it, I feel like we just need to make a turn. Just kind of like what Teresa was doing. Turn on a worship song and...
Okay.
Kind of...
Oh wait,
Becca,
shut up. I was hoping you were
going to
say that.
I'll have to get all that set up here in a minute, but we will do that. That sounds like a plan, definitely. A Holy Spirit plan. So, let's just go to the next screen again. I'm just going to read the scripture. Trying to figure out how to open it, I'm just going to open it with scripture, amen? Matthew 16:22 says this, Then Peter took him, being Jesus, aside and began to rebuke him. First mistake, Peter's trying to rebuke Jesus. Who else in here besides me knows that's a mistake?
Yeah, man.
Far be it from you, Lord. This shall not happen to you. Now listen to what Jesus says, and this is so powerful, and I've missed it so many times until this week he showed it to me.
Yeah.
But he turned around and said to Peter, "Get behind me, Satan." Everybody say, "Get behind
me,
Satan."
Satan.
You are an offense to me, for you are not mindful of the things of God, but the things of men. Now let me ask you something. This was a moment for me when he showed this to me. What song we just talked about? This is how I fight my battle?
Yeah.
When you fight people, you're usually fighting people in front of you, right?
All right.
We're all the time talking about, let's get Satan out of here, let's get all this, let's do all that. What did Jesus do? Jesus told his enemy to get behind him. Where are we the most vulnerable at? Behind us, our backside. So Jesus, I believe in the midst of this, Jesus was not just saying something to Peter, but he was telling us something. Why are we trying to face things when we need to put them behind us? The way that we fight the enemy, I mean, we want to go head strong and head first and go at him and do all of this, fist up just like that and pull a Mike Tyson on him and do all of these things. Muhammad Ali. I don't even remember what Muhammad Ali was. Fly like a butterfly, sting like a bee. Yeah, we want to try to do that. And Jesus is saying to the enemy, get behind me.
Come on.
Get behind me.
Get out.
Are you hearing that? Yeah. Get out of the way. Get behind. First and foremost, because Jesus knows Satan has no ability.
Yes, he's not scared. That's why he said get behind.
Yeah, get behind me. He can't touch him. He can't hurt him. And there's people in here right now. There's people who are going to watch this on YouTube or whatever that need to hear that word right here, right now, that as long as you've got Jesus with you, you can have Satan behind you because he can't touch you.
Right.
He can't mess with you.
That's right.
Stop letting him do it, because the only way that he can is when you turn like this and let him come back in front of you. And when he does that and you realize he's done it, you just go again and say, get behind me, Satan. You get behind me because you don't have the right to see my face.
Right.
You hear me?
Yeah, I hear you.
As children of God, we are holy and righteous.
Come
the
on.
Devil is sin. He
Woo!
Is evil.
And yes.
Sin and evil cannot see the face of God.
Yes.
Therefore, sin and evil, if we are righteous and holy in God's righteousness,
Woo!
In God's holiness,
Come
by
on.
The blood of Jesus, the devil doesn't have a right to see our face.
That's right.
Come on.
He needs to get behind us.
Amen.
So if you want to know how to fight your battle, do exactly what Jesus just said here.
Get behind me.
Get behind me, Satan. Problem is, and I'm just going to be real about this. We got all this stuff about faith over fear going on right now. It all got started. I mean, it started before then, but definitely over the last 2 years because of COVID-19, everybody's saying, faith over fear, faith over fear, faith over fear. And it's good, it's good. I mean, we do need to speak that out, don't we? Because we want that to become true in our lives. Exactly. But we're all the time talking about our COVID-19, but what about our finances? What about our relationships? What about our family? What about our friends? What about our jobs? What about anything and everything in our life? What about our food pantry and our house? What about those things? Why are we still trying to fight those head on? Why are we trying to fight those battles head on? Get behind me, Satan.
Yes. Amen.
Get behind me. You don't have the right to any of these things in my life. Because I'm a child of God. Jesus tells me that because I believe in Him, I am a child of God.
Amen.
It's what my word tells me, and my word is Jesus, so therefore I believe it, that I am a child of God, devil. You can't get in front of me. You, as John Cena would say, you can't see me. Amen, Brian. Wrestling or not, John Cena's right on that one.
I think that's a t-shirt we need to work on. Devil, you can't see me.
Well, let's be honest about it. Let's be real. Let's be truthful. Why are we trying to fight battles that God's already won for us? That's why we can put Satan behind us. Why are we fighting all this mess and trying to do all of these things and saying, God, I don't know all this stuff. I'm trying to figure all this out. And literally, all God is saying, I've already won this for you. Just tell Him to get behind you.
Yeah. Come on.
Why? Why are we doing all this stuff? Brian, can you hear me more for me? Because
it doesn't recognize
who it is. That and the fact is they're not walking in the faith over fear.
Come on.
We're walking in the faith over fear because if you're walking in the faith over fear, then you have enough faith to tell Satan to get behind you. You have enough faith to tell your problems, get behind me. You have enough faith to tell depression, get behind me. Anxiety, get behind me. Heartache, get behind me. Sickness, get behind me. Broken bone, get behind me. Because my bones are broken. My body is made whole. I mean, let's be honest about it. What are we saying in the Lord's Prayer again? Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Where's the devil at in the midst in heaven? He's not in heaven. He's not there. Because he's been put in his place. You hear me? He's been put in his place. And you have the ability. You have the authority. You have the power in your life through the name of Jesus. Speak the name. I speak Jesus. You have the power in that name to speak to that issue and say, in Jesus' name, get behind me. But you've got to realize something. Can't have any fear, because if you have fear, it's not going to work.
Come on.
David Hogan. Some people love that man. Some people hate that man. But he is a strong man of God. He's seen over 600. Some of you have heard me say this. Some of you haven't, so be ready. But this is confirmed. He has seen over 600 people raised from the dead. Woo!
Come on.
You know why?
Because he believes it. If you believe,
and he has no fear.
You receive.
If you hear the man speak, you will find out he has no fear.
Come on.
He doesn't. He's not worried about what the world thinks. God radically got a hold of him. Jesus radically got a hold of him. And from my understanding, he picked up from where he was at and went to Mexico. And that's, I think, where he still resides. I don't know if he still resides there or not, but that's where his main ministry is. And that's where a lot of this stuff happens, including either his son or his grandson. Happened in that his grandson told, I've heard the story, the testimony of his grandson raising, being raised from the dead. And yet in Matthew 8, he tells them to do what? Mm-hmm. Heal the sick, cleanse the lepers, raise the dead, and cast out demons. Mm-hmm.
But don't get excited.
But in the midst of doing those things, here's the thing. Here's the thing. You can't have fear. If there is an ounce of fear, then you're being like James in the double-minded situation.
Come on.
That has to truly be, it's not faith over fear, it's faith marks out fear.
Come on, that's right.
That's where the trueness of it is at. Because just like this, and yes, Amber, I borrowed your phone and I didn't tell you. Because I didn't have a computer with me, I don't have the iPad with me. I've got my phone with me, but my phone's being used for YouTube, so I had to steal Amber's phone. Sorry, honey, not really. Therefore, I remind you, 2 Timothy 1, 6 and 7. Therefore, I remind you to stir up the gift of God.
Come on.
Therefore, I remind you to stir up the gift of God. Are you hearing me?
Yes.
Therefore, I remind you to stir up the gift of God, which is in who? In you.
Come on.
Therefore, I remind you to stir up the gift of God, which is in you through the laying on of hands for God.
Yes.
Which means this is what he's done, okay? For God has not given us a spirit of fear, but of power and of love and of a sound mind. Well, some people say, yeah, he's given us no spirit of fear, but of a sound mind. Power and love, yeah, but it's sound mind. You got to operate in a sound mind. You got to. And then they start going, well, if you're operating that sound mind, that's why this, and I ain't even getting into all of this. Just being honest about it. Give me every excuse under the sun, but it's still stupid if you're going into the sound mind thing and you're using that as an excuse not to do what you're called to do.
Come on.
Are you hearing me?
Woo!
That sound mind is developed in you for your calling, for the gift of God on you to do what you are called to do. And if all you were doing is using the excuse, well, he's giving me a sound mind. He may have given you a sound mind, but you're not using it if you're not walking in your calling.
Come on.
That's it.
Come on.
If you're not walking in the ministry of your life, your calling is your ministry. Your calling is your family. Your calling is what God has put upon you to help people that you don't even know.
Yep.
Oh, but if I stop and try to help somebody on the road, they might do something to me.
Ouch. You kept me from doing that today.
Not mistaken, there was 10 people that Jesus said, be healed, go and prove yourself, go and be proven clean. And 9 of them did exactly what Jesus did, but one of them, realized the true nature of who just said that to him. And realized that even though Jesus said that, he didn't really have to go to be proven clean. He needed to go back to the one who he knew cleansed him.
Come on.
And thank him for it.
Come on.
Because he realized at that moment that the one that just did that for him, he needs to go thank him for it, because that one that thanked him had just put Satan behind him.
Come on.
He didn't need the legalism anymore because he had experienced Jesus.
Amen.
He'd experienced Jesus. And you can't experience Jesus if Satan's right in front of you. You can't experience Jesus if Satan's over here. Satan's over here. The only way you can experience Jesus is Satan behind you, because any other place he can distract you.
Come on.
And mess with you. and tear you up in one place and there from the other. There is a lot of good Christian women and men that, and he's done it to me, okay? I'm going to be straight with you. He's done it to me, and I've had to repent, and I've had to tell Satan to get behind me because he's tore me down. And I didn't even realize it was too late. I was walking in the, God's got me, I'm a man of God, and all these things, and I wasn't trying to be proud about it or anything like that. I was just walking in it because I knew that I need to believe what was going on, and I need to speak over these things. But the problem was, is sometimes if we're not careful, we'll speak it so much that we turn it into a pride issue for ourselves, which allows Satan to come right back, straight, right down in front of us.
Come on.
Come on, that's true.
And then we can't see God because Satan's in front of us because we've let pride get in the way. Get behind me, Satan.
Yes.
Get behind me. For if God is for me, who can be against me? I can do all things through him who strengthens me. But if you really listen to the content of Philippians 4:13, I want you to read this. The only one I had on me, that's the only one he gave me, guys. So he's just following through me right now on this and just telling me where to go. Hallelujah. He's so good. But listen to how Paul gets to this. I preached this before, but somebody needs to be reminded of this. So we all know Philippians 4:13. I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. I just said it. But what's it leading up to?
Come on.
Let's go back to verse 10 and hear what it says. But I rejoice in the Lord greatly, now that at last your care for me has flourished again. Though you surely did care, but you lacked opportunity. Not that I am speaking, now listen to what he's saying, because this is where it comes in. Not that I speak in regard to need, for I have learned in whatever state I am to be content. Not satisfied, but content. There's a difference. I know how to be abased, and I know how to be abound. Everywhere and in all things I have learned both to be full and to be hungry, both to abound and to suffer need. I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. I feel very led right now. I have never read it in this translation, but I feel very led right now. Where's it at on your phone, honey? The Passion. Yes, I'm finding it for me. Because I need to read this in the Passion for some reason. Never read it in the Passion, I just feel led to do it. We don't have it, I got a different one I can use.
We've never downloaded it.
Never downloaded it to yours? Okay, you don't have it, that's fine. Hold on.
Sermon,
Brandon. Let me just get some sermon.
Well, I'm going to read it another one while I'm waiting on him. Not that I am implying, this is the Amplified, not that I am implying that I was in any personal want, for I have learned how to be content, satisfied to the point where I am not disturbed or disquieted in whatever state I am. I know how to abase and live humbly in strenuous circumstances, and I know also how to enjoy plenty and to live in abundance. I have learned in any and all circumstances the secret of facing every situation, whether well fed or going hungry, having sufficiency and enough to spare, or going without and being in want. I have strength for all things in Christ who empowers me. I am ready for anything and equal to anything through him who infuses inner strength in me. I am self-sufficient in Christ's sufficiency. Did y'all hear that? That explains that. Not pretty. Let me read that again. I have strength for all things in Christ who empowers me. I am. Are you ready? Anybody say anything, Kim?
Come on.
Ready.
Am I ready? Are you ready? I am ready for anything and equal to anything through him who infuses, what's that mean? Puts into you. pushes it right into you, infuses inner strength into me. I am self-sufficient in Christ's sufficiency. That fires me up. That fires me up. Do you realize what's going on in the midst of that? Don't worry about it, Brian. I'm gonna read it from one other translation that I think will work. One more translation. I am just as happy with little as with much. With much as with little, I have found the recipe for being happy, whether full or hungry, hands full or hands empty. Whatever I have, wherever I am, I can make it through anything in the one who makes me who I am. How many did you find again? I don't know, but there you go. That's some powerful stuff. I read the same three verses out of three different translations. But inevitably in the midst of those, they mean nothing until you tell Satan to get behind you.
The passion is
okay. Okay, well, here we go. One more. The only reason I'm doing it on this is this is what I feel led to do. I'm not telling you this because I'm in need, for I have learned to be satisfied in any circumstance. I know what it means to be to lack, and I know what it means to experience overwhelming abundance. For I am trained in...
I don't know if y'all ready for this, y'all.
Do it. Y'all ready for it?
Ready.
Are you ready?
Ready.
For I am trained in the secret of overcoming all things.
Come on.
Whether in fullness or in hunger, and I find that the strength of Christ, Christ's explosive power, infuses me to conquer every difficulty.
Come on.
For I am trained in the secret of overcoming all things, whether in fullness or in hunger, and I find that the secret, that the strength of Christ's explosive power infuses me to conquer every difficulty.
Yes.
Hallelujah. So I ask you this question. And I ask it to you as boldly and as caring as I possibly can. Why is Satan still standing in front of you?
Come on.
Call me late.
What are you waiting for? Woo! You know what to do? What are you waiting for? I need to pray over you in this. What are you waiting for?
Get behind me, Satan.
Get behind me, Satan.
I mean, what, why do we fight these battles? Why do we go through all of this junk that the world tries to throw at us? When the world inevitably, what it's throwing at us is the devil throwing it at us. So, I ain't even using this mic right now. Why in the world are we trying so hard to do stuff? It's just like the word that God gave me to give Brian. Stop trying and let him do it. Let him do his thing. All we got to do is say the name. Speak
Jesus.
The name. That's all we got to do. And put Satan in his place, behind us and not in front of us. That's inevitably why, thank you, Jesus, that's inevitably why God told Lot and his family, don't look back. Because if Satan's behind you, what are you looking at if you look back?
Satan.
Look forward. Look to what God has for you. Look for what he is doing in the here and the now.
Amen.
Big windshield, little rearview mirror. Stop looking in the rearview mirror.
Come on.
That's where Satan's place is.
Come on.
Look at the big windshield of what of all the possibilities and all the things got going on. There's so many Christians. Oh my goodness, there are so many Christians today. And I speak this, saying this about Christians, not to put them down, but to literally, in a sense, put them in a position of power so that they can understand they don't have to deal with it. But there are so many Christians that are struggling and going through so many fights that they should not have to fight. They're going through all of these ridiculous, unneeded, obscene battles because the devil is just torturing them and they don't even realize it, but they continue to let it happen because they don't realize and understand the power of what Jesus is saying here, that Satan does not have to stand in front of us. We do not have to put up with his mess. We can literally tell him to get behind us. Put him in his place.
Somebody was mad in our place.
Yeah. So why are we mad at the devil?
Woo! We ought to be mad at the devil every day.
Oh, we should be, but how many people say that it's said, well, be careful, don't give the devil too much credit. You know what? I don't want to give the devil too much credit. But I'm also not going to give God credit for what the devil's doing.
But
you hear me?
We're going to heaven and he's not.
I'm not giving the devil credit.
Amen.
For what God's doing, and I'm definitely not giving God credit for what the devil's doing.
All right.
Yes, God works all things out for the good of those who love him. And all of that that goes on with that. But if I'm sick, I'm not going to stand and say, praise God for my sickness. Because God didn't give me that sickness.
No, but praise him in spite of. Yes.
But in the midst of that praising, I'm going to stand. I'm going to tell the devil, get behind me.
Come on now. That's it.
I'm going to get behind me because he's the one that's throwing it at me.
That's right.
Yes, there's a spiritual war going on. And we play a part in that spiritual war. And we need to stop this mess. We need to stop this mess of fighting a fight that is not ours to fight.
Stop fighting the fight that's already been won.
Yeah. And in the midst of this, a lot of the reason people won't tell Satan to get behind them is because they're afraid of what might happen. Because you don't, in worldly life, you don't want your enemy behind you because you don't want to get stabbed in the back, right? So what does Jesus say here when he's saying, get behind me, Satan? He's literally saying to us, if you'll put Satan in his place, I'll take care of the rest.
Come on.
You don't have to worry about being stabbed in the back. Because you got my armor on.
That's right.
More than that, you don't have to worry about getting stabbed in the back. Because as soon as you put him in his place, I'm going to put him in his place. And I'm going to bound him where he can't touch you again because you finally woke up and were finally brave enough to put him where he goes. Because that's what I've been waiting for your entire life, is what God is saying. I've been waiting your entire life for you to tell the devil where he needs to be, put him in your place, put him in his place so that I can move you where you need to go. But he's been blocking you because you keep letting him have that position. Quit letting the devil have the position in front of you.
Amen.
That belongs to God. The devil's not in front of me. He's not in front of me. What is in front of me is all the struggles in life I've got going on. The devil's not in front of me. My finances are in front of me. My sickness is in front of me. My heartache is in front of me. Losing people that I truly cared about is what's in front of me. Don't you dare tell me it's a devil in front of me. All these things are in front of me. Well, tell them to get behind you too.
Come on.
All right.
Because if you want to be freed from those things, and that's the problem, people won't tell those things, which is the devil too, let me just be honest with you.
Yes.
People won't tell those things to move because either they don't want them to move or they don't care. If you don't care, I have to dust my feet off.
Come on.
Because I can't help you if you don't care. Amen?
If they don't receive you, dust them off.
And another, I can't help you either. God can't help you if you don't want it. As Mick has said to me many times, I'm, for the rest of my life, Mick, I'll never forget you saying that. The first person ever said to me, that God is a gentleman. If you don't want it gone, it ain't going nowhere.
Come on.
You gotta want it gone. The moment you want it gone, he'll come in. And how do you say you want it gone? Get behind me. Get behind me. Get behind me. Because that is how I fight my battle. Mm-hmm. Because I speak the name of Jesus. Because he is good. He is gracious. Abraham, you're drinking my water real quick. Sandra, but she felt it. I know as soon as this touches your hand, you're going to feel it. It will start working as soon as this touches your hand. I'm going to say a word to you. As soon as it hits you, you're going to feel his presence. These will start doing the work. I may not even say a word to you, but I don't know. If he gives it to me, I will. But part of it's going to come when this touches you. He's using this thing for some reason today. I don't know why, but he is. Go ahead, ladies. Bless her. Bless her, Lord. Bless her. This word today that God gave me was for a lot of people, Gloria, but it's especially for you. Especially for you. You go either in one or two different directions. You either try too hard or you give up too easy. You need to stop both. Let him be him. All you got to do is tell your problems to get behind.
Come on.
And don't let them come back around. That's what's the thing is you know this. You know this. God's already showed this to you. And you know it. But you keep letting that circle come around. You keep doing a 360. And God is telling you right now, I don't want a 360 out of you, Gloria. I want a 180. Turn around to me and stay at me is what he is saying. That's what he's saying. So right now, Jesus, just bless her. Bless her with your presence. Bless her with your mercy. Bless her with your grace right now. Just bless her, Lord. Bless the Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Bless the Lord. Bless the Lord. willing to let him do it, he's going to restore some things to you that you lost long ago. But you have to let him do it. You have to let him do it. To let him do it. So Lord, give her the strength right now. Give her the strength in Jesus' name. Give her the strength right now. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Thank you. All those things be gone right now in Jesus' name. I break break the spirit of witchcraft off of her. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Thank you, Lord.
Praise Jesus. Always coming stronger.
Praise Jesus.